Welcome to Legacy IAS Academy. Today I am going to discuss editorial analysis of Hindu newspaper, that is Scale Up India's South Korea Bilateral Partnership. First of all, we will try to understand the context of this article. Here we know that like Indo-Pacific region has emerged as a key theater of engagement with return of great power competitions. China's growing capability and influence across the Indo-Pacific provoke pressing questions of US strategy in this region. So we know that Indo-Pacific region is very, very important as of now, and USA has put it all its energy in Indo-Pacific region. Here we have one important country, that is South Korea. And here we are going to analyze India-South Korea relations. When we see how this article is important for us, we have GS paper 2. In GS paper 2, we have a topic like bilateral, regional, global grouping and agreement involving India or affecting India's interest. So first of all, if you see the location of South Korea, this location of South Korea is very, very important. First of all, South Korea is a democratic country, and South Korea is supported by USA. Okay, South Korea is advanced country. Advanced means technologically also and financially also. So South Korea is a democratic country. South Korea is supported by USA. South Korea is advanced country, and the location of South Korea is geostrategically, geopolitically, for resources also, for sea lane of communications also is very, very important. So when we see India, so you see India and here we have South Korea. We know that, okay, China's presence is continuously increasing in Indian Ocean. China has created many ports like in Sri Lanka, Hambantota port, Gwadar port in Pakistan, maybe other port in Bangladesh also, Myanmar also. So China's presence is continuously increasing in Indian Ocean, and that is somehow compromising India's strategic interest. Same way, India also tried to increase its influence in South China Sea or Western Pacific region. So here this country, South Korea, which is very near to China, is very, very important, or strategically very, very important. Like Sri Lanka is strategically important for China because Sri Lanka is very near to India. Same way, South Korea is very, very important for India because it is very near to China. So strategically means security purpose, it is very important. Defense purpose is very important. And because all important countries are engaging in this particular region, that's why South Korea is important. India is doing trade for this route. To secure the trade, the South Korea is important. And for resources also, like metallic resources or other resources are available in the ocean, for that purpose this South Korea is important. So here we have seen the location, how this location is important for India. We can see this map also. This map is important. Here we have Sea of Japan. This side we have Yellow Sea. Okay. This side we have North Korea. North Korea share border with China. Okay. And this side we have Busan, Jeju, and this side we have Japan. So at least whenever you are looking IR, try to see the location of that particular country, because in the prelims, UPSC is asking location-based questions. So this location somehow very, very important geostrategically, geopolitically for India. And second thing is, South Korea is an advanced country, and we can get advanced technology, we can get capital, and we can improve our trade also. So for economic purpose also, South Korea is very, very important. Now, need for India's South Korea strategic partnership. Like we have a strategic partnership with South Korea. So one thing we know that, like assertive China, China's following, I can say that expansionist policy. China tried to expand its own territory, and China generally have border dispute with neighboring countries. So assertive China, when China's influence is continuously growing, how to make a balance, for that purpose South Korea become very important for India. Need to protect maritime sea lane of communication. As I discussed, South Korea is also important to protect see Renault communications whenever our trade is going on, how to protect our seat. For that purpose also South Korea become important. Economic convergence, always remember, like India is South Korea developed country, India is developing country. So what the goods produced by South Korea, they are important for us. But the goods produced by India, they are important for South Korea. So for that purpose also, economic engagement can be improved between India and the South Korea. Now, North Korea-Pakistan axis. We have seen North Korea is a communist country. North Korea is very close to China. And North Korea is also close to Russia. This North Korea-Pakistan axis is continuously growing. So we can utilize axis of India versus India and South Korea. That relation will be very, very helpful. And we know that US helped a lot to South Korea because of US help, South Korea is very advanced and developed country, and that will also help. And US, India and Australia, US, India, Australia, Japan has started Quad. Okay, this Quad is somehow giving direct challenge to China, whenever North Korea, then if South Korea is going to join this Quad also, again it is very, very important. And global commonality. At global level, both are democratic, both respect human rights. This also help to improve the relationship with South Korea. So we can say that India and South Korea do not have much conflict, do not have much competitions. Only both can progress together, only both can promote cooperation. For to utilize these objectives, India and South Korea have started Comprehensive Economic Partnership Agreement. Comprehensive Economic Partnership Agreement basically liberalized trade in goods and services between India and South Korea. So whenever we have started we have free trade agreement, like preferential trade agreement, free trade agreement. Later on, we have comprehensive economic partnership agreement. Comprehensive economic partnership agreement is next level of free trade agreement. So here, whenever a comprehensive economic partnership is signed between two countries, it somehow helps to improve the trade between two countries. Framework to strengthen economic relations. This comprehensive economic partnership give a framework where how Korean goods can come to India, how Korean companies can invest in India, how India can improve its own trade with South Korea. So this framework help how both the country can interact with each other. Step to ease of doing business. We know that India have a challenge regarding ease of doing business. Because of that reason, these foreign companies are not able to invest in India properly. This framework provide how Korean company can come to India and they can invest also. So this is very, very important. Transparency in trade rule. Now, because this is making one rules for Koreans, rules for South Korean company, rule for South Korean people. They know that, okay, if they are going to trade with India, these are the rules and the regulations they are going to follow. And improve effectiveness of the competitiveness in services and manufacturing. We know that, okay, South Korea is an advanced country, advanced technology, and they have capital also. If those things are coming to India, it is going to improve the competitiveness of India's goods at foreign countries. So you see, comprehensive economic partnership agreement is very, very important between two countries. Now, what are the challenges? First challenge, as of now, we have China. China's and South Korea relations are continuously increasing. China become important trade partner for South Korea. As of now, when we see China has economic linkage with Japan also, economic linkage with India also, economic linkage with USA also. If you see, that is the challenge all the countries are facing. One side, South Korea have strategic importance. Other side, South Korea have this economic importance. So South Korea somehow tilted toward China. That is the one challenge as of now we have. Okay. Second thing is, we have framework, comprehensive economic partnership agreement, but the framework is not utilized properly both the countries. These rules which provide ease of doing business to Korean companies in India is not utilized properly. Despite strategic partnership, no specific bilateral goal are identified. Both the country have similar strategic interest, but not able to create a bilateral relationship regarding strategic level. Lack of ease of doing business. That is the biggest challenge. Whenever a Korean company want to invest in India, they face a lot of hurdles. So those hurdles we have to address. Like deterioration relationship between Korea and Japan. Like Japan is also very important and Korea is very, very important. But Japan may be more important than the Korea. If India have to make a relation between two countries, it becomes sometimes very challenging how to make relationship both countries when they are fighting. For example, now one side we have USA, other side we have Russia. How to make a good relationship with two enemy countries become again very, very challenging. And Korea absence from Indian Ocean region security apparatus. So Korea is not interested to ensure security in Indian Ocean. So these are the some challenges we have between Korea and India relations. Why we have to do? South Korea's shifting perceptions about economic engagement with China has influenced its strategy toward Asian power, including India. That perceptions we have to break down. What opportunities South Korea is getting from the China, that opportunity can be provided by India or maybe other like-minded countries. That perception we have to stop. Then India need to take advantage of this opportunity as South Korea can be a major economic partner of India's economic growth. India is emerging economy, India is developing economy, India has huge demand, India has a population. That demand is very, very important for South Korea also. So we have to attract South Korea toward the India. Such engagement will help enhance India's strategic leverage, especially in Indo-Pacific region. So we have seen how South Korea is important for India, what are the significance both the countries have, how comprehensive economic partnership agreement provide a framework where both the countries can cooperate together, and finally what are the hurdles we have and how these hurdles can be addressed. So hope you are able to understand India-South Korea relation. Thank you for watching this video.